Hello everyone. I'm sitting in an amazing chair. If you look at it carefully, I've been looking at it very carefully. This is in the home where I'm staying with a good friend. It's one of those chairs you'd find in the very old Reformed churches where the elders or deacons would sit in rows ready for their role in worship or their role in communion. And I was sitting in one, sitting up straight, the original cushion, probably long gone, but the one here is similar, and it's pretty hard work if I had to sit for an hour and a half. But it's a beautiful piece of furniture. I love it. But it's not a symbol of meaningful worship. It's a symbol of something of a bygone era. Hey, I wanted to talk to you more about that fountain. And maybe I can go and show you some pictures later, but right now there's two very big dogs right outside and they want to play with me. And I come off second best, so I'm going to talk about it. I want to talk to you about persistence. Not persisting on some things that someone else does, but persisting with something that we know is good, even when it seems really difficult. So that fountain, it was a pile of rocks, and I talked to you about it at a previous Pauline's place. Well, it's on the way to being something very beautiful. The original shell, which you saw a few months ago on Pauline's place, has now got water in it and a couple of goldfish. And it's a trickle, a beautiful flowing trickle. It's all the original plumbing, but the heartache and persistence it took for Bob to make it happen, it's really something. And he's still a long way off. He's still got to adjust the lighting, the power, and dig some trenches. But you know, his persistence has attracted help and enthusiasm from others. And he wants to share it with people to make it a beautiful place to sit. So we'll have a look a little bit on that. But hey, what are you persisting at? That's good for you and good for others. Really important. In the Bible, in 2 Peter, it says that, you know, and with knowledge comes self-control. And in self-control, it brings perseverance. And in perseverance, it brings godliness. I used to think, godliness, suddenly I've got an aura of something perfect, or I walk around looking prayerful and peaceful all the time. No, that they're connected. The knowledge brings and is a part of the self-control, and the self-control is a part of the perseverance. And the godliness, the godly person, someone who keeps going in love for the sake of others, doing good for themselves and for others. It's a wonderful message. You know, later on in that chapter, the writer says, and I'll keep on reminding you of these things, even though you know them, but you might forget them. And when I remind you, it'll be as if you know you are in the presence of truth. Well, whatever you're facing, I think to be in the presence of truth isn't a bad thing, is it? To know that you're working towards something bigger than you. Well, persist, my friend, if you're working at something difficult that's taking a long time. Keep going. I need to practically persist in a way to relate to these two big dogs in a way that my body can cope. So I'm going to do that soon, and I want you just to have another look at that fountain. God be with you, and when you've looked and finished here, just take a look at this video. It's called Persistence, and you'll enjoy it.